Hello folks, I'm in the note folder once again, and this time I have two more empty JS files, writeFile and writeFileSync. Now in a previous video, we have discussed about the writeFile and writeFileSync methods in JavaScript and what is the difference between them. If you have not already watched the video, I recommend watching it first. So in this video, we will discuss about these methods. So first of all, I will import the fs module, and to do that I'll write const fs equals to requireFS. Now I will use this method, so I will write fs.writeFile, and here we can see the arguments. The first argument is what is the file we want to write, and so inside the files folder, let's say I want to write a file called question.txt, and the next argument is what we want to write. In case of the writeFile method, the argument was the encoding, and in this case the second argument is what we want to write. So let's say I will write, is there anyone else in the competition? Question mark. Now the third argument in this case is the encoding. And lastly, we can do one console log. Let's say thinking. Now lastly, to test the asynchronous nature of JavaScript, I will write another console log. Yes, there is. Okay, now let's run this file. So we will write node and writefile.js. So think about it, what will run first? Ideally, if we run line by line, this should come first, and only then yes, there is should be printed, right? But let's run and see. As you can see, the line number 12 is printed first, and then we get thinking and whatever is inside this code. So what happened is, because this fs.writeFile is an expensive operation, because it has to write a file and this is more difficult, so JavaScript printed this line number 12 first, and this is the async nature of JavaScript. Because this task is expensive, it didn't block the code here. It kept on running the remaining code, and when this task is complete, it has made the question.txt file. So inside the question.txt file, we can see that we have what we have asked to write. Is there anyone else in the competition? So that is how this writeFile method works. And now to make it better, we will add some errors. So what if we get an error reading this file? So to log that error, I will pass the argument of error here. And then I will write, if the error is true, then I will log the error, and let's put it like this, error, and I will log the error. And else, if we are successfully able to read the file, then we can. Okay, so let's delete the question.txt now, and let's do something. It is difficult to make an error like this. Let's remove it too. Let's change the name of the files. So now if we write, as we can see, we get an error and no question.txt is being printed. And now let's change it back to where what it was. And now let us print again. We get the question.txt. Now let's move on to the writeFileSync method in JavaScript, where JavaScript will execute the code synchronously and it will block the writeFileSync code, and only then it will go to the next lines. So once again, we will import the fs module. So require fs, and how we will execute the writeFileSync is a bit different, and that is, we will first of all once again give the files, and inside the files let's give another file spongebob.txt. And the next argument is what we want to write, and that is, we all know that SpongeBob SquarePants is the strongest. And the next argument is the encoding, and that's it. It doesn't have any callback function, and then we will simply print something else. Let's say I agree. What about you? Now let's run this and we will see this time, first of all, and also one more thing is there. We have to lock something else over here because we need to know which line is being executed first. Let's say, let's write here, does everybody agree? Okay, now let's see which line gets executed first. So as you can see, this does everybody agree. This line is executed first and only then this it comes to this line. And that means JavaScript is blocking the code over here. It writes this file and only after that it goes to the next line. And let's go to the text file. We can see that we all know SpongeBob SquarePants is the strongest. Now let's add some errors, and this time we will add errors by the try catch block. So first of all, we will try this part over here, and if we catch some error, we will log the error. Let's say once again it's the same way, error, and we will log the error. Now let's try to make some error, and we will make it like this. So as you can see, we get the error, and the error comes from here, error whatever is there. Okay, so let's put it back to as it was, and let's remove the SpongeBob and run again. As you can see, we get the spongebob.txt. So that's it for this video. This is the basic difference between the write file and the write file sync methods in JavaScript.